It's a strange feeling, every day waking up and wishing to go home. Never did I imagine the first day I sat in the auditorium or walked through the west wing to my locker that these walls would become my new home. My home has a door of glass that is always open. My home is where friendships were formed, where I scored my first goal, where I joined student council, where I gave my first speech and bowed at a Bono show. I never would have thought that the seats in the library would be a place of familiarity. Never would I have guessed that I'd miss the seats in room 454 with the jug that came along with them. What I would do to sit with our class in the green-tiled cafeteria just one more time. But each day apart from home, we remember how we were raised. In our home, we raise our hands in knowledge. We raise our fists as we scream black and white. With a hand, we raise each other up on the field. With our hearts, we raise one another up with Kairos love. We raise our voices in the four more years chant, a chant we wish to receive just one more time. But Fenwick, we rose above the challenge that swept our world. And this made our class truly special. Now we will rise together as we graduate, and forever will our home, the home we found so much within, be the place we were raised. The drink you spill all over me, lovers spill left on repeat. Mom and dad let me stay home, we tried to crazy get away.
My favorite memory at Fenwick, I'd say, is Kairos.
My favorite memory at Fenwick is definitely Kairos.
It's definitely Kairos.
I was able to lead and go on the regular Kairos, so that was by far, you know, one of my favorite memories at Fenwick.
I love seeing Mrs. Wong's different outfits every day, like when she dresses a lamp.
My favorite memory at Fenwick is probably getting a triple whammy from Miguel. That was really nice, although at the time I really was mad at her.
Sophomore year in Mr. Tranquina's period 11 class, the projector would go out every day at the same time, and a kid in my class would literally write down the time every single day until it made Mr. Tranquina go crazy.
My favorite memory at Fenwick would probably be freshman year, where Lauren, Noah, me, and Lauren Hall were downstairs in the Lawless Gym. Girls had their freshman basketball tryouts, I think, that day, and Noah bet me $20 that I couldn't make a three-pointer, and I was like, okay, bet, like, I'll take you up on that. And so I went downstairs, so I was like, Lauren Hall, give me the ball. And she literally threw it to me, and I shot a three-pointer, and it went in, and all I remember is, like, Lauren grabbing the camera, and it's like, oh my god, and everyone was so excited. It was the funniest thing ever.
My favorite memory at Fenwick would be getting pressured by some of the upperclassmen freshman year in varsity golf, who ended up becoming some of my best friends for life.
One of my favorite memories in freshman year was in bio with Mr. Winnick, when we had like a lab where we had to just wait for like 20 minutes before anything happened. So me, David, Jay, and Noah, we were playing Fortnite on our iPads because that was like cool at the time. And Mr. Winnick came in and joined us, so he played like as one of the people.
When Jahaz improvised his whole speech but still got an A.
My favorite memory of Fenwick would probably be when I was rehearsing for Beauty and the Beast my freshman year, and the stage was super slippery, they hadn't redone it yet, and I was a knife, and all of a sudden we were doing a kick line, and I had to run to my spot, and I kept sliding because the stage was filled with sawdust and like wood dust, so I slid right off the stage directly into the pit, and it stuck with me as, like, I thought it was so embarrassing at the time, but I'm looking back and it's so funny.
I feel like we missed out on just the feeling of like being seniors, like having our whole entire class like in the school together and like being together. We don't have that.
Definitely senior year. I think everyone can agree. We just missed senior year.
But Fenwick has really made it, like, I know they've been trying their hardest to give us the most that we can with this crazy year, so I'm grateful for that.
Same.
I feel like I missed out on the school spirit the most this year.
I feel like we missed out on every time when Mr. Groom like, seniors stay back and like getting yelled at after mass, like that's what I was looking forward to.
Yeah, I would agree. It was definitely that. definitely like seeing the lower half of people's faces. Like, I'm a huge social guy. I love like seeing people smile. And I know that sounds cheesy or whatever, but it's just like makes my day. So
honestly, just like being close to people, because when you're like 6 feet apart, there's like an element of a connection that's lost.
I wasn't here freshman to junior year, so I would say that.
So you just missed absolutely everything. Yeah. So you just didn't get any of it.
Definitely the pep rallies. I mean, screaming 4 more years at the freshman, I mean, that's one of the best experiences.
I'm gonna miss definitely the common goal we all have and determination as Fenwick students to avoid the second floor, to not get a jug from Miss McGall.
I'm going to miss all the friendships I had here, just being able to see everyone in the hallways and all the great teachers here and like all the memories that come with it.
Once a friar, always a friar. Like, I know it's so cheesy, but like it's so true. And like you just feel so loved and welcomed all the time.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna miss the most just like waking up each day and knowing that like I'm going to school with a bunch of kids that love me.
There's a lot of great people here at Fenwick. Yeah, just can't be replaced.
I think I'm going to miss like the small things. Like when you walk in and Mr. Richens like saying good morning, or you walk out and like give a weird fist bump or like handshake, awkward like thingy with Father Petticord. Like just the things that remind you that like this place is special.
The thing that comes to mind right now is I'm gonna miss rolling into the parking lot with my dad and like at the last second and getting a spot when everyone else is like scrambling in the garage. So yeah, the parking perks. My Kyra's mom, shout out Grace McGann, in her talk she said that it's not about the place, it's the people. And I definitely think that Fenwick has shown me so many different people that just make it my home, and I'm so thankful for that.
Definitely the people, just like the classmates, the teachers.
Like our relationships at Fenwick, I think, is so unique to any other high school, and so many other schools don't have like the relationships and the friendships that we have.
Yeah.
I mean, Nurse Paith is like my second mom, so that makes it my home.
What makes Fenwick my home is definitely the people. The teachers, everyone here is so amazing. Everyone has your back. And it's just like every morning when you walk in the building, like, you know you're gonna smile at least like once that day, and everyone just makes you feel so special. So yeah.
Fenwick feels like my home because of, you know, people like Miss Maeve White. I think the people is what makes Fenwick. I don't think that there's anything particularly different about Fenwick other than the people that attend it and the caliber in which they like push themselves and believe in themselves and do the same with like their classmates.
Describe Fenwick in one word, I think I'd say dedicated, because I feel like everybody here is really dedicated, whether it's the staff, whether it's the students. I think we're all dedicated to our own grind and to Fenwick as a whole.
Fenwick in one word, united.
I would describe Fenwick as innovative, especially this year because of COVID, obviously. We've still managed to find so many ways to connect with each other and continue our families.
If I could describe Fenwick in one word, it would be family.
Definitely family.
Supportive, because everyone just supports all your endeavors and everything that you want to pursue.
I would say pride. I feel like everyone who goes to Fenwick is proud to go here.
Home.
You stole mine.
I'd say indescribable.
Some advice that I give my freshman self would definitely be to be more confident in yourself and just be open. I know everybody says that, but I feel like if you just stay shy, you won't experience it the most.
I would say to not be afraid about anything. I would join every club, every sport, because that's how I made some of my closest friends.
Yeah, if I could tell my freshman self one thing, it would be talk to every single person and make sure that you know every single person's name before you leave, because each person has a different story and we're all going through a similar experience of being Fenwick students, but we all have so many differences in our lives.
Don't fall asleep while driving.
Yeah, don't fall asleep at the wheel.
You will get in a car accident. It happens.
Yeah.
And your mom, mine is Terry, she will not be happy.
The advice I would give to our freshman self is don't go to Jewel Osco every day and eat donuts for dinner before you go to a 3-hour long rehearsal.
Choreography rehearsal.
Yeah, that's a really bad idea. Mm-hmm. Don't do that.
And also don't miss the bus the first 2 days of school and make your parents come pick you up.
Don't go to Nazareth!
Next year, I'm going to Tulane.
I'm going to Notre Dame.
I'm going to Vanderbilt. Anchor down.
I'm going to St. Mary's College in Notre Dame, Indiana.
Ground
to
ground.
I'm going to Notre Dame.
I'm going to University of Illinois.
Are you, baby? Who are you? Once again, I am a child. I let go of everything that I know. Yeah. Of everything that I know. Yeah. And nothing hurts anymore. I feel kind of free. We're still the kids we used to be. To see if I still bleed. Yeah. And nothing hurts anymore. I feel kind of free. We're still the kids we used to be. Yeah, yeah. I put my hand on a stove. To see if I still bleed. Yeah. And nothing hurts anymore. Feel kind of free. We're still the kids we used to be. Yeah, yeah. I put my hand on a stove to see if I still bleed. Yeah, and nothing hurts anymore. I feel kind of free.
That was a 10 out of 10. Had some steak.
Savage at this point.
Noah John Grimes.
Yeah, I put my hand on a stove to see if I still bleed. Yeah, and nothing hurts anymore. I feel kind of free.